Hi, Sunday school friends. Welcome back. We are, I'm going to move ahead here. Here we go. We are wrapping up our study through the Old Testament in the book of Joshua. Now, the beginning of this book, we find the Israelites on the banks of the Jordan River, and they're looking across at this city called Jericho. And the city had super high walls to protect it. Now, remember, this is the second time in 40 years that they've seen the city. Remember, they were here once before, and the last time they chose to turn around and walk away. They saw the beautiful fruits that grew there. They knew all about the food and water and the land that God had promised them, but they chose to focus on the problems that they saw and walk away. But this time, they're going to make the right choice to trust God. Now, the Israelites had a new leader named Joshua, and he tells the people, get ready, guys. In 3 days, get ready. In 3 days, we are going to be crossing that river. We're taking over Jericho. This is the land that God had promised to us, right? And so the Israelites, they're on the banks of this river, and I'm sure they're thinking, how are we going to get across? You know, they're carrying all their clothes, their food, you know, and they're thinking, are we going to swim across with our stuff on our backs? I mean, how on earth are we going to get across? I bet they were probably wishing that they had a boat, you know. They didn't know how they were going to get across, but they were going to trust the Lord to get them there. And you know what, friends? He did exactly that. This is what happened. So they're marching down towards the river, and the priests, like the spiritual leaders, the pastors kind of, they're carrying the Ark of the Covenant, which was their reminder as they had been traveling in the wilderness all these years that God was with them. Remember, we talked about the tabernacle, how they worshiped God. So this was one of the ways that they remembered that God was with them. So that's what they're carrying. And a crazy thing happened, a miraculous thing. As they were walking to the banks of the river, you know what? They walked across on dry land. Once again, we saw how God had parted the Red Sea for them before. Well, once again, God comes through. They cross that river on dry land and get to the other side. And when they got to the other side, and Joshua was near Jericho, he looked up and he saw someone standing. Let me move my face out of the way here. He saw someone standing in front of him with a sword drawn in his hand. And Joshua, he went up to him and he said, are you for us or are you for our enemies? Like, are you someone from Jericho? And right out of the book of Joshua, this comes. Neither, he replied, but as commander of the Lord's army, I have now come. Then Joshua, he fell face down in reverence, in respect. And he said, what message does my Lord have for his servant? The commander of the Lord's army replied, take off your sandals, for the place where you are standing is holy. And Joshua did so. He was obedient there. That's what we see there, friends. Now, this must have been amazing. God tells Joshua the plan, and together they prepare for battle. And God tells Joshua exactly what the plan is. He says that they were going to march around the city once with all the soldiers, and they were going to do this for 6 days. And on the seventh day, they were going to march around the city seven times with the priests blowing the trumpets. Here's a trumpet. So they're blowing the trumpets, really loud, right? And they're going to have the whole army give a loud shout, and then the walls are going to come tumbling down. Now, I can only imagine Joshua, he's trying to explain the plan to his soldiers who are ready to go into battle. And they were told, okay, for the next week, we're going to be marching and blowing some trumpets, and we're just going to be walking around. Now, if the Israelites didn't think God's instructions were a little crazy. The people of Jericho certainly had to think so. Can you imagine them looking out over their tall walls like, what is this army doing? They're just marching around. They were expecting the Israelites to attack them, you know, to try and build ladders to climb up the wall. And here the Israelites are just marching around the city, blowing their trumpets. So the Israelites may not have understood the instructions, but they obeyed them exactly. See, they had learned that when they follow God's commands, that He was going to give them the victory. God had taught them this over and over again, that when you follow Him, nothing is impossible. In the Bible, if we've seen anything in these last 5 weeks, friends, have we not seen that following God is the best way to live our lives? And you know what, friends, for the Israelites, God came through once again, just like He always does. On the seventh day, when the people finished marching around the city and the priests blew their trumpets, whoa, and the people shouted, the walls came tumbling down. God did exactly what He said He would do. The people trusted God and God came through for them. Throughout the story, we're reminded over and over again that God can be trusted and that He does exactly what He says He will do. Look at what happened when the Israelites finally put their trust in God. A follower of God, that's you and me, right? We are to be obedient to the Lord. And if we are, we'll see that He will do great things in our lives. And the Israelites, you know, they had God on their side, so nothing was impossible for them, right? They were able to conquer this huge city just by walking around and blowing their trumpets. And it's still true today, friends. Nothing is impossible with God on our side. So if you guys will join me, let's say a little prayer and close out the lesson. Dear Heavenly Father, thank You for always keeping Your promises to us. Thank You for loving us. We love You back so much. Please be with us this week. Amen. All right, my friends, I'm going to let you go. Hey, I hope to see all of you this Sunday at 12 o'clock, 12 to 2. We're doing the drive-through celebration at church. We're going to be handing out treats. I'm just going to tell you, I think there's some ice cream involved, guys. So you definitely want to come to that. I'll be there and I would love to wave to you and see your smiling faces. And also, I want to encourage you, go on our Sebastopol Christian Church website, sebchristian.com. Have your moms and dads help you. Under the Children's Ministry tab, you'll see my fall challenge to you. And you know what? You can even bring me your drawings if that's what you chose to do on Sunday, if you want to drop them by, and I will have some prizes ready for you. So I challenge you to do that. I would love to see them. All right, friends, have a great week. I hope to see everybody on Sunday. Bye.